Okay, people, so I am here and I'm going to try and demonstrate the video tagging features of this camera. And I'm going to try and catch motorcycles coming by this corner. And you never know when they're coming around. So I thought I'd try it. So right now I went into the menu settings of the camera and I put it on tag mode. And let's get it rolling. So you press this button, and now it's constantly playing or looping. And then we'll see, whenever a bike comes around, I'll press the tag button, and then we'll see if it tags. So it's on a 10-second 10-second interval. And we'll see if I can do this with my gloves on. Hopefully, in the future, they will put a button on the remote so that we can use the remote. But for now, you have to reach up and tag it yourself. And the cool thing is that, they redesigned and everything, and they put the buttons on top and I thought, oh, what's the big deal? Yeah, it looks prettier. But now I see it has a functionality, because when you raise your hand, it's easy to access the buttons when you have it on the right side of the helmet. So easy to start tagging, because you can tell where the button starts. Here. And it's on the 10-second interval, so when I press the button. Oh, here come some bikers or moped riders. So from the time I press the button, it'll backtrack 10 seconds and catch the present 10 seconds and the future 10 seconds. So you have a bunch of 30-second clips, and you can always stop it early if you feel like you got enough. Or you can tag on an extra 10 seconds if you wanted to. And I am dying in this heat. So yeah, I'm starting to. Oh, did I get that? I'm starting to get the appreciate all the little things that, on paper, sounds nice, but once you get it into use, it sounds pretty, it works really good. It works really good. So, the really cool thing is, even though you press the button and you feel like you've missed the action, it goes back 10 seconds or up to 5 minutes back if you set it that way. So, a lot of tourists here today. Oh, are you gonna climb that wall? So, I'm sitting here in the hot sun with my helmet on. So, what else can I talk about? They have a new photo burst mode. And it takes a rapid succession of photos, I think up to 10 a second, if I remember correctly. And now the photos are 11 megapixels, which is really nice. And the quality is improved, the sound is really improved, and this video tagging thing is really, really cool. And then because you're more likely to catch the moments. Because if you just have the remote, you hit it, it might be too late to catch that moment. And then when you have the collected all the moments that you want, then you don't have to go digging through, sit there and watch the video and edit out all the stuff that you don't want. Is a limo? I don't want to get that. It's a nice touring bike over there. Oh, here's a bike. Let's see. Hi. They're like wondering, what is she doing on the side of the road? And then it beeps to tell you that the 30 seconds is over. There you go. Beep. The one thing that I wish they would improve on is the night. There's no night mode. It's not as, I don't think it's as good as the previous drifts. Hopefully they'll fix that in the, here comes another bike. In the next firmware update. And hopefully they will also add the start feature of the tagging to the remote. Because I do notice that, let's say it's rolling and you tag it and you press it again or whatever, it makes a clicking sound. And I don't, and then when you press it, of course, it's going to, it might shake the camera a little bit. Oh, nice dog. So, and of course, it has all the wonderful features of the previous drifts. It has the rotating lens. It has the big LCD screen. Well, this one's even bigger. It's 2 inches, and it has a really good battery life. It has the strongest or longest battery life on the market. And the cool thing is that this camera was set up so that it would eat less battery. Don't know if you can hear me better with this thing down. So the built-in LCD screen does not eat up as much battery as a screen that is an accessory that you have to buy. Oh, did I get it? I might have missed it. Another thing is, for battery life, the remote control, if it's Wi-Fi, then it will eat a lot of your battery up. Whereas the Drift HD, the Ghost, well, the Ghost remote is run by a radio frequency, so that does not eat up as much battery as a Wi-Fi remote control. So, I think I hear another bike coming. Oh, there it is. So, hopefully by the end of this recording, I'll have like a bunch of 30-second clips that, hi! 30-second clips of just what I want, of the only things that I want. Oh, there you go. I did get it, so it beeped. And here's another guy. Yeah, I'm gonna wait till he leaves and then press the button. And then it'll backtrack, make sure that I got it. It's really cool because you can actually miss the action and still get it. So this is cool. It's kind of like a little time machine. Oh, there's another one. See, if I just had the remote control, I totally would have missed that. So as you can see, it has a lot of applications. If you're, I don't know, trying to land a triple, you're an ice skater or something, and you just want to get that instead of all the other stuff in between, or you know, you're a skateboarder, you're landing tricks or something, or I don't know, events that are unexpected that you can't anticipate. This is great for that, and you don't have to go through so many memory cards to get all the shots that you want. You won't miss it. You won't have. You'll do a lot less editing, buying a lot less memory cards. Here's another guy. You see, I can start it with while having this my gloves on. And I must look really weird standing on the side here. Everybody's staring at me. See what I did for you guys? Minuses. You know, it's so much easier to navigate this new menu. But the one thing, when you press on the icon that you want highlighted, it gets like slightly bigger and it turns green. But it's still to me, still kind of hard to see. You know, I'm just nitpicking here. I'm really nitpicking. Maybe if they made it like a square appear around that icon that I wanted highlighted. Otherwise, it's kind of hard to see with just the color change and the slight variation of size. I don't know. Well, I think this ends the video tagging part. Let's take this thing underwater. Oh yeah, that's another new thing about this camera. It is waterproof up to 3 meters or 9 feet. So you can do water sports with it, but if you want pretty underwater pictures, I still recommend the case because without it, things will be blurry. But it is waterproof, and so you can just take it and go and make sure you have the waterproof rear hatch tight on there. So let's go.